are you two doing? Okay, can I talk now?
We're heading up to go see the penguins. Just sort of doing rounds and go pop in and see how things are going up there. Hi, buddy. We're behind our African penguin exhibit, and we are in the animal care space that's directly adjacent to the habitat. The animals are provided, we call them a hut. It's a plastic lumber house that these guys will use as a nesting area. And so they find it very comforting. I built these in my garage with my son a couple of years ago, and they've worked out really well. My son, when he comes to visit, likes to brag that he helped with that, so. African penguins catch people off guard when they find out just that there are penguins in Africa. They think of penguins as being on snow and ice and in cold weather. They're more of a temperate species of penguin. You find them off the coast of South Africa and Namibia.
You got lost in the crowd, kid.
Good girl.
Come on, boop boop. Boop boop. Thank you. Hi. This is Akilah, and the little nugget behind the door is Rafiki.
What are you doing? Hi, why are you being shy?
Rafik, what are you doing, mister?
He's avoiding the camera.
You don't know that.
He saw it went like this. He would be what we call a juvenile, so he's already fledged those downy feathers that chicks will have. Come on, buddy. Come on.
Working with African penguins is the best feeling.
There you go.
There you go. You know where you're going.
It's almost like your animal at home. They can become your best friend, but it's at work, so you're getting paid to do this.
Good job.
You keep your eye on him.
There you go. Come over here.
When they hear that whistle, pretty much indicates to the animal that they've done something that is desirable and to expect positive reinforcement as a result of that.
So if you want to reach out and give them a little rub on the back. Oh, you are hungry, huh?
We're looking for the animals to be nice and calm, collected, and not trying to crowd, trying to peck other animals around them while they're eating. And that just makes for a much more calm environment.
Seems a little calmer here than I anticipated.
Mm-hmm.
To be completely honest, I had never been a big bird person, so. What are you two doing? Okay, can I talk now? I'd always wanted to work with dolphins. I didn't really like birds. I thought they were loud. I thought they were smelly. I thought that they were dirty. And they are all of those things. But I had one jump in my lap and she melted my heart. And so now I'm a penguin guy through and through. All right, well, I'm gonna end there. Seemed like relatively successful. Rafiks, come on. Yes, he is a youngster. Come on.
Good job, buddy.
What do you see, bud? You see that? Oh, I saw that too. There's a fly in here. He's trying to track it. But they're very, very inquisitive, very curious animals, and they pick up on very subtle things in their environment, and he's gonna get it too. He's very good at that. African penguins are considered an endangered species. Most of the threats that African penguins face in the wild are environmental, the biggest one being a lack of food. We're finding that penguins have to swim further and further to find the types of fish that they're eating and are actually in direct competition with commercial fisheries. Georgia Aquarium is passionate about African penguins and we want to make sure that we're doing our part. If we don't do something to help, then these animals won't be around. There's a facility in South Africa called SANCOB. One of the things SANCOB does is rescues, rehabilitates, and releases African penguins. They work with rangers that patrol the African penguin colonies, and if they find animals that need help, they'll rescue them up and they'll take them over to SANCOB for rehabilitation. This is the time of year where the sand cub facility is receiving a number of penguins. So I'll be heading to South Africa along with my colleagues Jason and Stephanie so that we can help the team at Sand Cub and learn from them.
So this is our pen area.
How many birds do you rescue every year?
Typically, it's 2,500 birds that come to our center every year. Typically, when they come in, they're debilitated and they can't swim for an hour like the stronger ones can. So that's where we want to get them. So we kind of push them a bit to get stronger. And it can take anything from 2 weeks to a few months, and then eventually be released. There's not a better feeling than when they leave the center and they enter the water for the first time.
Yeah.
It's really great.
So you have 24 birds here today?
23.
Holy smokes. They're hungry. So you have 357.
We are feeding the birds this afternoon. This session, these chicks get a combination of formula and fish.
These guys get a max of 4 fish a day. So you can see this guy is a little hungry.
Sand Cub has had a wonderful partnership and friendship, in fact, with Georgia Aquarium for many years. The keepers come with a different perspective. They are coming over to this rehabilitation center in South Africa where they're going to learn how to work with African penguins that are wild. What we gain from them is some insight into behaviors, enrichment ideas, things that they work with more specifically in their institution. So it really is an exchange of ideas and we both benefit from it.
433.
The tube feeding of the chicks actually gives them a lot of extra calories. Basically, kind of like a fish smoothie. I'm learning so much from everybody, the handling, you know, even just, you know, the practice of doing it over and over again.
Good stuff. Food coma.
The biggest difference between feeding here at Sand Cub and feeding the African penguins that we have in the Georgia Aquarium is the amount of interaction that we have with them. We don't want African penguins here at Sand Cub to become used to people because we don't want them to seek people out there in the natural environment.
Oh, crap. Empty boxes can't hold us. Come on, babies. Other way.
Dennis, okay.
You need help?
Have to go away. So they've all escaped from where we had them, which is funny, but that makes it more difficult to feed the one that I'm trying to feed, which is the one in my You have to go now, sorry.
So I have to find these 5 birds and that group of 25 birds. So the bands are numbered, so I have to go through and look for these individuals, and they're going to be put into the nebulizer. The vets or vet techs will come down and do a weekly check on them. If they hear any congestion or any crackling or wheezing while they breathe, then they will be prescribed nebulizers. So it's a 10-minute, potentially twice a day prescription where they go into this little box and smoke and fog kind of comes out and it kind of helps them clear out their lungs.
So he's looking for five birds?
Which I, of course, wrote on this hand, which I need to glove. It is going to be a challenge.
That's one right there.
Perfect.
It's like a needle in a haystack here.
Man, some of these guys are saucy. These guys are getting ready to be released. So this is exactly the kind of behavior that we want to see from them.
Ooh, little needles.
They're really feisty, they're really wiggly, they're kind of biting us. That means that they have not become habituated to people. Very different from what we expect to see at the aquarium. 448,
yeah.
407.
Just one.
Just one. They all keep moving, keep biting.
Oh, that hurt.
390. Woo, okay. Tomorrow is release day. Looks like there are about 12 to 15 on the list that are going to be released, so we're getting them ready. Tomorrow we'll check up their health, make sure they get the last doses of medication that they need, and then we'll bring them out to the beach and let them go, which is why we're here and which is really awesome. Worked up a sweat.
Take out this tray of fish to go to our home pen birds, the permanent birds that stay here, and feed them kind of as much good fish as they want to eat. All right, so we've
Should I just join you?
Yeah.
And you'll just call out a name? And
I'll call out a name. You can take them off on the Thursday p.m.
Okay.
Slot.
Oh, you have somebody that's eager.
They're hungry.
So you have some fans, Jamie.
We have. They know when it's their lunchtime.
They do, yeah. This is the area of the hospital they call home pen. Home pen is home to animals that either require a lot longer of a rehabilitation process before they can be prepped for release, or are animals that have been deemed non-releasable for generally a medical condition that prevents them from being able to thrive in their native environment.
It's their quality of life, really, when we're keeping them here. So here's one of our stumpy birds. That's Carsten. So the foot was amputated because it was flicking back. It happened a few years ago. So she's walking around on it perfectly fine now. And she has a mate in here, she has a nest, quite happy with one foot. So that was Q.
That was Q.
Morgan Smudge.
Cedric.
Cedric yeah. will be in the pool.
Okay, Cuddles.
Cuddles has eaten.
Beak Boy.
Beak Boy hasn't eaten yet.
It's quite interesting because these are animals that are handled a little bit more in line with what we would see in our penguin colony in Atlanta. You know, there's not as much emphasis on maintaining a separation. There's animals that are a little bit more dominant in here, and there's animals like Steve over there that are just happy to be right next to Jamie. And...
I love this part of my job because, I mean, you get cuddles from penguins every day, so... All right, just Crazy String.
Hi, String.
Oh, there you are. Hi.
She loves interacting with us, so she'll you know, girl. Kind of snuggle in there.
Nice, sweet girl. She's a very... So she has some neurological issues,
she does,
doesn't she?
And she's blind in one eye, and she is a little bit loopy, but she's, girl. Yeah, she's good.
Good girl. Yeah, good girl.
Hi, String.
Morning.
Some fresh boxes here for our release so that nobody falls out the bottom of these boxes.
Exciting day.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to quickly just go through plan of action.
Is there anyone on this? Just check if they need meds or whatever. Wafers, tube, onto that side.
Okay. And all of them need to be weighed?
Everyone needs to be weighed.
Okay.
Okay.
Five fish, and then you can go to the release side.
Okay. They need to weigh 2.6 kilos before release. There's a lot going on, so we're preparing birds, but we have to separate the ones that are going out to be released and those that are not. We'll be driving about 2 hours to the release site, so we want to get them fed, get them a little bit calm, and then get them into their boxes before they go. 2.6.
2.6, you can go straight over to that side.
Going to be releasing 14 of the supposed 16 that we had planned for. Two of the guys were just a little bit underweight, and so we want to make sure that they're at a really healthy weight before we release them, so that they're nice and fat and they got a good cushion. This is the last free meal you're going to get. You better eat.
I'm just going to cut the tag off. I need the other side. All right, you're good. Just make sure he doesn't bite me.
Yep.
Now I'm going to check transponder. Now the head measurements. Okay, and he can go into that box okay. Over there.
Oh, bee!
So now taping up.
I'm super excited for our release. I've been in the field for almost a decade, and this is the first time that I'm going to be experiencing something like this.
Okay, he's good to go. You can pop him in there.
Can you believe we're going?
No.
I'm so excited.
I'm gonna cry.
I know.
So just put that one on top.
It's a little chaotic. The animals are a little bit out of their element right now. But it's short-term stress for a long-term gain, and so we're really excited to get to this point.
We're going to Stony Point in Betty's Bay, and Stony Point's a nature preserve where there's an active colony of African penguins.
Be able to see birds that get to go back to their natural environment is what it's all about. I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it.
One, two, three.
That's awesome.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, that's wicked.
This is amazing. This is the culmination of all these great people doing such great work at Sand Cob and doing things for these animals. These guys wouldn't have any other chance, right? So to see them get to this point and release back into their natural environment is an amazing experience, and I'm grateful to be part of it.